I'm Sam the Cell. Phone, that is. But I do other things, like hosting videos. So I've been thinking about our relationship. You know, between you humans and us phones? I mean, think about this. As the world population gets older, more and more people are developing chronic diseases like high blood pressure and diabetes, many often needing daily medications. Now, how many of you forget to take your medicine as you're told to? For people with certain illnesses, forgetting their drugs can be life-threatening. So what if there was a pill box that knew when you didn't take your medicine and sent you a text message to remind you? It's called SIMpill, and it's an example of mobile health. So what is mobile health, you ask? According to the World Health Organization, mobile health, or mHealth, is the use of mobile devices, such as cell phones and tablets, to support medicine and public health. mHealth is part of electronic health, or eHealth. eHealth is electronic processes and communications that support healthcare and public health. You may have heard of mHealth. It's gotten a lot of attention in recent years, especially from Bill and Melinda Gates. Their charity, the Gates Foundation, offers grants for developing low-cost cell phone applications for global health. So what does mHealth do? The World Health Organization breaks down mHealth into six initiatives. Number one is communication between individuals and health services. This includes telephone help or advice lines and emergency toll-free numbers. Did you know that not every country in the world has 911? Number two is communication between health services and individuals, such as text messages, reminding HIV patients to take their medicine, public service announcements encouraging people to get tested for HIV. Initiative number three is consultation, between healthcare workers such as midwives in remote areas talking to doctors about problems. Number four is communication between agencies using cell phones to respond to and manage public health emergencies. Nigeria used this during the Ebola outbreak last year. Number five is health monitoring and surveillance, like using Facebook and Twitter to check for the spread of flu. And lastly, number six is access to information for healthcare professionals. This includes the use of electronic patient records. So you're probably thinking you would need to go out and buy the latest smartphone, right? Well, we are pretty great. Just the other day, I found out that my brother's girlfriend's cousin is working with the Gates Foundation in a vaccination registry. She is used to scan fingerprints to keep track of who has been immunized. She's helping to lower the number of redundant shots given and to increase the number of people vaccinated. Pretty cool, right? I thought so. But our parents and grandparents' generations are doing some great things too. And that's why we're going to talk to my grandma, Angie.
That's right! We're being used as low-cost existing technology to improve health outcomes in low-resource areas. So come with me to our next video and see great ways mHealth is working around the world.